Hello everyone, my name is Idris Tadilen. I'm from Mechatronics Engineering Department. We are going to explain exploratory data analysis for our dataset. But before we get started, we would like to explain our dataset briefly. So what is full shot learning? What is the problem? In our dataset, we will take a look at vaccination, a key public health measure used to fight infection. Vaccines provide immunization for individuals and peoples, and enough immunization in a community can further reduce the spread of diseases through herd immunity. In this manner, when a vaccine for the H1N1 flu virus became publicly available, United States conducted a national H1N1 flu survey. There asked the respondents whether they had received the H1N1 and seasonal flu vaccines. There are additional questions covered for their social, economic, and background and opinions on risk of these illnesses. Why is flu shot learning important? Beginning in spring 2009, a pandemic caused by the H1N1 influenza virus named swine flu swept across the globe, and researchers estimate within the first year it causes between 151,000 to 525,000 deaths globally. And what is the machine learning task for our dataset? We are going to be predicting two probabilities. One for H1N1 vaccine and one for seasonal vaccine. In this context, our dataset is a classification problem, and so it's a supervised learning problem. And from now on, Metam will continue with the samples and features.
I am Metam Uzun. Now I will tell you about the details of the data that we have. We have two types of data sets. The first one is a train data set and second one is a test data set. There are 26K samples and 38 features in both data set. In the next five slides, we will see the names of the features and what kind of value they have. You can skip Idris slowly. Fourteen of these 38 features have categorical, and 24 of 38 have a numeric value. Okay, stop.
Hi, I am Mert İhsan. We detect outliers and drop them. Sometimes outliers indicate a mistake in data collection. Other times they can influence a data set, so it is important to keep them to better understand the big picture. What we use, why we used, we used local outlier factor. It obtained local density from the nearest neighbors. Why we use, it's contamination is the proportion of outliers in the data set. Neighbors represent number of neighbors. Metric is the distance measure. Next, thank you. Before the outlier detection and drop process, our data is consist of nearly 27,000 samples. We use local outliers factor and we find 1,384 outliers, and we drop them from the data set. After the drop process, sample number decrease 25,000 samples. Finding missing values and field. Any feature is important for quality of the prediction. So we don't want to lose for feature or dead feature samples. We need to fill properly dead feature samples. We first tried filling with average most frequent values of features, but there is a problem. Because of our data contains too much binary features, it consists of 0 and 1. Also, we have encoded variables. How we solve that problem? We use replace with random value of features. That is solve our issue. Feature selection. In that part, we analyze with correlation and observe some features are not related with our targets. So we drop some features such as respondent ID, health insurance, and child under 6 months. For example, in that figures, we can observe it does not affect other features importantly. Feature split. CERN's MSA contains 4 types of choice. MSA, non-MSA, principal, and non-principal. So we need to decide split the features into 2 feature. We created MSA feature which contains MSA and non-MSA. Other one we created principal feature which contains principal and non-principal. For other features, no need to for split or create new features. Encode categorical variables. We encoded the categorical variables because machine learning models require all input and output variables to be numeric. This means that if data contains categorical data, you must encode it to numbers before you can fit evaluate a model. After the encode categorical variables, we encode our 14 categorical values to numeric values. Treat as ordinal, converts the variable into single numeric variable, enumerating the original values. In that case, the new variable would have a value of 0 for low, 1 for middle, and 2 for high, but it can be added with domain of the dataset. Then now, Idris will continue about our visualization and graphics.
When we are explaining the relationship between features and the target ve values, we take help from the visualization method.
May I ask a question?
Yes, sir.
I couldn't understand what is your target class or what is your target in that data set. So what do you try to predict?
We are predicting the vaccines that people taken for the H1N1 flu.
It's the binary classification problem.
Yes, sir.
What are these binary classes?
Can I explain?
Yes, please.
It is multi-label classification. We will predict 2 feature, H1N1 and seasonal flu.
So it's binary classification, not multi-class.
But in the competition, they say there are 2 type of label, which is multi-label. You will predict one of them and the other one.
So it's binary. If it's something is 2 means binary. If there are 2 classes to predict, either people will have H1N1 or the flu, so whatever. So it is 2 classes. There are 2 classes. Am I right?
But we will predict independently scale of 0 and 1.
So for example, 0 and 1 means that's a binary classification. Am I right?
You are right. But for example, H1N1, some person 0.5 probability of getting. Vaccine.
We are not talking about probabilities. We are talking about labels. So for a sample, there are possibility of 2 labels. Either H1N1 and the other is?
Seasonal
one. Seasonal. So there are only 2 labels, like cats and dogs. Am I right?
You are right.
Yes.
And it's a binary problem. Am I right?
Actually, it's not because we will predict a scale of 0 and 1.
Then it's zero not or a classification problem. Then it's a regression problem. Am I right?
You are right.
Then think and speak. Now I'm asking again for all of the members of this team. The machine learning task is classification or regression?
I read the article about that, but
you don't need to read the article. You need to check the data set.
Okay. I think we we got mistake about that.
İdris, what do you
think? Yes, sir.
So do you think that it is a regression problem or classification problem? When you look at the data set, so you didn't show me the data set at all. Why you don't show me any snapshot of the data set? Do you have a snapshot of the data set from the orange? Do you have a snapshot?
No, but you can show the orange.
Yes, sir. Can show it.
Okay, so what I'm suggesting that, did you check the target column? Is the binary classification or just a regression?
Binary.
Binary, sir.
But Mert is talking about some probabilities. So if you are talking about probabilities, it's the regression problem. Mert, what you are talking about?
There is a...
But in the binary, it must be 0 and 1. We will predict scale of 0 and 1. It can be 0.5 or 7.
Okay, what means 0.5 means what?
Probability of people getting H1N1 or seasonal flu vaccine, getting vaccine.
You are saying or. I am asking 0.5. What does it mean? It is cat or dog? You are saying cat or dog. Which one is correct? I am proposing a simple question. If I provide you a picture, I am asking, is it dog or cat? You are saying that 0.5 cat and dog. Is it possible? Is the valid answer to that question?
No.
So I am asking again, did you check your data set? Did you really understand what is the problem? How to use this data set? For what reason you are going to use this data set?
Sir, actually, we made research about that, but
for example, person 50% can be get H1N1 vaccine.
So what does it mean 50%? So
0.1.
So it means that he or she will get both of them.
Yeah, we will predict both of them, but in the different label feature.
Okay, then it is a binary classification. It's not regression, because in binary classification, as we discussed in 2 weeks, 3 weeks, of course you need to predict some values, but then you convert these prediction into labels. If it is 0.7 dog, it means it is dog. It's not 0.7 dog. Am I right?
You are right.
So it's a classification problem. But if you are talking about the shoe size, if the shoe size is 46, it is 46. You cannot say that it's 47. Or you cannot say it's a big shoe size. That is classification. I am asking again and again, again, 3 times. Is that a classification problem or regression problem, Mert İhsan?
It is classification.
So don't speak about the 0.5, 0.8. I don't care about this. Is it a dog or cat problem? Or is it a, what is the shoe size problem? Which problem is that?
Dog or cat.
Dog or cat.
Dog or cat.
So why you are talking about 0.5, 0.8? I don't care this. You don't care this. In your classification model, your answer will always cat or dog. One of them. One or zero. You never see 0.5, 0.8. At the end. Am I right?
Yes, true.
Yes, hocam.
Yes.
But you are explaining your exploratory data analysis, but you are not aware of the problem. You are talking about like that you are dealing with a regression problem, which is not. So, and you couldn't present the data set very well. I haven't seen the data set yet in your explore data analysis. So it's very strange. Why you don't provide any samples? So show me the some samples and show me the target values. Yeah. Where are they?
We can show it, sir.
But in the presentation, it must be in the presentation, right?
Yes.
The first slide must be that, the first slide. Your first slide must be a snapshot of your data set. Look, there are 10 rows. These 10 rows, each individuals. So look at this is the target value. Target is flu or seasonal, H1N1. You see that these are the categorical values. So we are going to do a classification, binary classification. But you are very confused with that. Do you understand my suggestion? Do you understand my comment, Mert?
Yes, I understand, hocam.
Because you said first multi-class, then you said it is regression. Now, I think it is binary classification. It's not multi-class, it's not regression. But you are very confused in a team. As a team, you are very confused. So you don't know what you are dealing with. Okay, continue.
So when we take a look at H1N1 knowledge feature, and on the left-hand side, first column indicates zero. That means
no knowledge. Is that a feature or is a target? You are confusing with terminology. H1N1 vaccination is a feature or is a target?
It's a target, sir.
So, but you are saying feature all the time.
I'm just talking about the H1N1 knowledge feature.
Okay.
So, on the left-hand side, zero, that means no knowledge about H1N1 flu. And on the middle column, one, yeah, that means a little knowledge about H1N1 flu. And the third column indicates two, that means a lot of knowledge. And for those blue areas, shows us the those who are not vaccinated in these situations. For the second graph, it shows us seasonal flu vaccination probabilities based on behavioral antiviral medicines. And from now on, Metan will continue with the...
In this distribution charts, we can see the relationship between age distribution or age features and seasonal vaccination targets. I think it's clear in this image that the rate of vaccination in humans is increasing with the age. Next. Teacher.
Could you please go back? Here you are showing the age for seasonal vaccine, right?
Yes.
What about the H1N1?
In this chart, I only show for seasonal vaccine.
Do you understand my question?
So yes, I understand. But
predicting if the person ready for, I don't know, seasonal or not, but you need to use the H1N1 information as well, I believe.
Yes, you are right, but we want to show different parts of, because we have 38 features and we selected some of them.
You said that at the beginning, you just remove some features, drop some features because you think that they are not too important in prediction, right?
Yes, yes.
So did you analyze which features are most, looks like most related to the classification?
Yes, yes.
Which are these? So you, it would be beneficial if you present these features. Am I right?
You are
not
right.
Not random features, but the features that in the correlation seems to be very important for your classification. Do you understand this?
Yes.
Okay, continue.
According to data we have, only 11% of people are health workers, while 40% of health workers are positive about the H1N1 vaccine. This rate is only 18% in non-health workers. Based on the data, 71% of people don't have a chronic disease. 18 of people who do not have a chronic disease with the H1N1 vaccine positively. On the other hand, 27% of patients with chronic disease with the H1N1 vaccine positively. People with chronic disease, which we will understand from here, have a more positive stance towards the H1N1 vaccine. When we look at the race graph, the race with the highest probability is white with 49%, and the race with the lowest probability is Hispanic race with 32%. If we look at the distribution in general, the perspective on sensational vaccine in all races negative.
Everyone, this is again Mertisan. Probability of people vaccinated with H1N1 by gender. In this slide, we examine probability of getting vaccinated for men and women. Out of approximately 16,000 women, the probability of women getting H1N1 vaccine is 0.22 in our data. Women with a score of 0.78 did not get vaccinated. The probability of being vaccinated is 0.19 out of approximately 11,000 men, 0.81 men are not vaccinated. Next. Probability of people vaccinated with seasonal flu by gender. 0.49 in our data out of approximately 16,000 women getting seasonal flu vaccine. 0.51 section are not vaccinated. In the men, 0.40 out of approximately 11,000 men vaccinated, but 0.60 men are not vaccinated. Next, please. H1N1 vaccination probabilities based on behavioral avoidance, washing hands, avoiding contact, etc. We produce such a graph examining the tendency of people to get vaccinated with the precautions they take avoid getting sick. As you know, factors such as personal hygiene and avoidance of contact are factors that reduce the incidence of the disease. In the graph here, we determined that people who pay attention to factors such as personal hygiene have a 0.2 probability of getting H1N1 vaccine. Next, please.
Okay, in that time, I would like to interrupt you, Mert. Because you don't need to provide every feature in that sense. Because explorative data analysis does not mean that. Okay, so explorative data analysis means that you are analyzing. You are just providing the raw information for me. You are saying 55% this way. I see, but what does it mean for you? How would you use this information in classification or prediction in your machine learning task? That's important. For example, if I were you, I wouldn't give this kind of information, but I would provide you the for scales, the minimum and maximum ranges of this kind of videos, if you are gonna normalize it or not, if you are gonna convert to a continuous or discretize it or not, but you are just giving me raw information, what you are gonna do with that information?
We have binary features, 0 and 1. We don't need to scale of them.
So do you understand me? So you don't need to provide me. If there are hundreds of features, you don't give me the hundreds of features, percentages per sometimes seasonal sum, but you need to provide me, for example, both of them at the same slide. How many of them is get a seasonal flu vaccination, or how many of them get which one of them? So I can understand that at that time, if you provide this, if you can use this data to classify the some sample, probably or not, I would understand. But now I don't understand. For example, here, just the seasonal flu vaccination probabilities or the information. What about H1N1? It must be on the same slide. So we can understand that if there is a relationship with washing hands and selecting the one kind of vaccination or not. Now we don't understand. Do you follow me, Mert?
Yes, we do.
So by looking at this slide, could you tell me that if somebody does not wash his hands, he will choose seasonal or H1N1? Which one? Do you have an idea? If you don't have an idea, how the machine learning model would have an idea?
You are right, hocam.
So the whole idea is in explorative data analysis, you try to understand your features with respect to your target values. Your targets are two, either seasonal or H1N1. But you don't create a relationship between them. You are just giving me raw information, 50%, 10%, 50%, 10%. But what you are gonna do with that? Any idea? And by the way, you haven't shown the distribution of target values in the samples. Do you have any slide for that? How many samples chose the seasonal? How many of them chose the H1N1? Do you have the numbers for that?
Could you
show me these numbers?
We didn't present it.
So how do you know that? How is your database is balanced or imbalanced? Maybe if there are some samples, chose both of them?
Yes.
So did you check this? What's the number of people who chose both of them? Yes, get the shot for both shots. How many?
There are people, but
how many?
I don't know.
Because we are talking about exploratory data analysis. You have to provide me useful information from your data set. But you are giving me lots of information which does not mean anything to me or to you. Am I right?
You are right, hocam. I will be careful about that.
So I am repeating, please, I provide you the links to you. Many links, four links. And there are lots of tutorials on the channel. Your data, presented data must include knowledge. knowledge, not statistics only, knowledge. So you would say that, look, here we understood that the ones who washes the hands will only get seasonal one, not the H1N1. Would you tell me this by looking at this slide?
No.
Then why you are showing this slide? It is useless. This slide is useless. We cannot use this information for your classification. Am I right?
Yeah, you are right, hocam.
So what we are doing with that information? Why you are showing this information to me? So exploratory data analysis is done for getting insight to your data set so that you would understand what to do with that data set. Feature engineering, other stuff, or selecting your model, or scaling, normalization. There are many things you need to do. By looking and understanding data, and you are summarizing what you understand in that presentation, but you are just showing me some unnecessary, unuseful statistics, and you don't know anything about your data. I am asking you, how many of the samples got seasonal flu shot, and how many of your samples got H1N1 flu shot? And you cannot reply. So you have not gained any insight for your data set. Am I right?
You are right.
Do you follow me?
Yes, yes, sir. I couldn't hear you.
So please, please improve your EDA. Otherwise, it's not EDA. It's just mechanical things. Show me the every feature with respect to something. Something. Actually, you need to put some effort here. Showing me seasonal flu and H1N1, and compare these features with respect to these target values. Now you don't do this. You are just giving me some feature values. I don't understand what's the relationship with your target. What's the relationship with that target now? Only one seasonal flu. What about H1N1?
Next slide, I will.
But both of them should be on the same slide. So you would tell me that I understood from these numbers, for example, if I was a student, I would say that, sir, look at these slides. We understood that washing hands does not make change any in selecting seasonal H1N1. So we drop this feature. But you don't say, you are only talking about the numbers, and just giving me unnecessary information, unuseful information. It's what you are doing is not EDA. This presentation is not related with EDA. Do you want to continue? But don't continue with these kind of things. Just skip it. I don't care about this because it does not provide me knowledge.
Okay, then we will fix.
I have a very simple question. How many samples people selected the seasonal flu shot in your data set? How many of them already got the H1N1 flu shot? Very simple question. You don't know. So it means that you have not done the EDA properly. Metan, do you understand me?
Yes, teacher.
İdris?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So Mert, you need to improve this as soon as possible. This is not the EDA that I please. There are 15 tutorials on the channel. 15.
Okay, hocam. Okay. Can I use Python for that?
But you don't need to use the Python. You can use the Orange with ease. In 5 minutes, you can answer me this kind of questions. Please read the links that I provided in the documentation. I shared the documentation. It's on the Moodle. How to do an EDA. You didn't read this documentation, I believe. Because in that EDA, there is no such statistics. Nobody used this statistics. It's useless. It does not provide you any advantage. Okay? So,
okay, sure.
Do it again, improve this, and when you are ready, we will do another meeting with your team again. This is not the one that I can accept. Do you understand this?
Okay, okay hocam, yeah. Thank you.
Okay,
thank you,
please improve, okay? Please check some, read some resources, how to execute EDA. Read it, because you didn't understand what's EDA, I think. All right? I will give you a second chance for the presentation, but this time is the final time. Please try to understand what is EDA at all. First, understand the concept. Then apply the concept onto your data set. Is that okay for everyone? Yes.
Okay, okay, sir.
Okay, I will give you a second chance for you when you are ready, but it should be in a 1 week time, okay? Not more than 2 weeks, okay?
Thank you, sir.